Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. You are welcome to my YouTube channel Pharmacy with Hemant. Today I am going to explain about the second parameter of pharmacokinetics, that is distribution of drugs. My previous videos were on absorption of drug, which you can get in playlist named Pharmacokinetics in my channel, and also you can get link in description given below. So without being delay, let's enter into our topic, that is distribution of drug. Drug reaching to bloodstream or systemic circulation from site of absorption is not sufficient to show the action of drug in body. The drug which is present in blood should reach to all tissues and cell in order to show its pharmacological activity. So drug distribution is important. Drug distribution is the reversible transfer of drug between compartment, that is from blood plasma to other tissues. You can see in picture that from site of absorption drug reaches to blood plasma, and from blood plasma it reaches to several body tissues, and from several those body tissues drug come back to the blood, that is systemic circulation, in order to excrete from our body. So it is known as reversible transfer of drug. And as I already told you that the concentration of drug is important for pharmacological action of drug at the site of action. And distribution is important for onset of action, that is how long drug will take to show action in body, and intensity of action, which means the degree of strength or feeling well caused by using drugs. For example, if you are taking any antipyretic drug, that is paracetamol, to reduce your fever, if your fever is decreased from 102 to 100 degree Fahrenheit, then you can say that the intensity of action of drug is low, that is it can't reverse your body temperature to the normal. And next one is duration of action, which means for how much duration of time does drug will show action in our body, also depends on distribution of drugs. So distribution is the passive process for which the driving force is the concentration gradient between the blood and extravascular tissue, that is it doesn't require any energy or ATP. The movement of drug from blood to several tissues will continue until equilibrium is maintained between the blood and extracellular tissues. And there are some steps in drug distribution. There is first drug should pass through capillary wall and then from extracellular fluid to intracellular fluid through membrane of tissue cell, which you can see in this picture. See, drug is present in, on your left hand side, drug is present in blood vessels, and when drug molecules crosses the capillary wall, it enters in extracellular fluid. It is also known as the interstitial fluid. And from interstitial fluid, depending on their ionization and size of molecule, they can enter in intracellular fluid, that is inside the cell through cell membrane. Next topic is volume of distribution. Volume of distribution is defined as the volume into which the drug appears to distribute, which is measured in liters per kilogram, and it is helpful in the context of drug monitoring, as well as it gives information on how the drug is distributed in body and for calculating the loading dose. And from volume of distribution we can know that greater the volume of distribution, higher the half-life of the drug, and longer the duration of the drug action, that is drug will stay for a long time in our body if the volume of distribution will be high. And there are certain factors which affect the drug distribution, that is tissue permeability of drug, organ or tissue size and perfusion rate, binding of drug to tissue component, and miscellaneous factors, which we will explain in detail in my next coming video. So thank you for watching, friend. If you think this video was useful for you, please don't forget to like and share with your friends. And if you are new in my YouTube channel, don't forget to subscribe and press bell icon so that you can get notification for my new upcoming video. Thank you for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy, keep watching, be updated. Thank you.